So, friends and family, what are we up to today? It's Sunday, it's around 9:30, and it's still cool. It won't be for long, and that's been a problem here. It's nearly the end of, well, I guess it's about one day from the end of September. And we have continued in the 90s, and I just really haven't been able to get a lot done out in the heat. Really drags me down at my age. But today I got to get some seedlings in. I don't have a lot of ground prepared. It's going to be rather tough. We're going to beat some tomatoes and pepper plants in the ground, and I'll show you just how we're going to do it. Because this ground is not prepared. It's raw. It's hard. Stay with us. So here we are. We're up in the East Garden behind the house. What we're going to do today is right along here is we're going to put in those four beefsteak tomatoes and 4 cups of California Wonder bell peppers that we plan on growing through the remainder of the fall on into the winter undercover. But you see these Chinese privet that I cut down earlier this year? Well, I left a portion. Planned on cutting them straight to the ground, but the heat kept me from doing it. So today's the day. But look at just how much they've sprouted in probably a little over a month. These things don't give up. We're going to cut them flat to the ground, and then we're going to start driving in some tomato plants and bell pepper plants. And when I say drive, I'll go ahead and shoot the video on it, because this ground is raw, hard, and hasn't been worked in 10, 12 years. So stay with us. Okay, y'all. I went ahead and cut those Chinese privet down so I can start putting something in here. You know, I'd left them up about 3-4 feet because the tops were all tangled up. And I've been meaning to cut the rest of them down. Just hadn't got around to it. Well, I got them done today. And now I'll be able to drill the stumps. I'm gonna fill those up with a 5% vinegar solution. And I'm gonna keep putting it in there until it kills those things. And later on, I'll use charcoal, a little bit of diesel fuel, and I'll start burning them out. Now I still have to get the roots. That's all gonna wait till much cooler weather before I do that, probably winter. But since I had the chainsaw out, went ahead and got them all while I was doing it. So we'll walk over here and see what we got. I went ahead and got down this rather large one, and of course I'm using my Works 16 inch electric chainsaw. And that right there, about that size stump of tree, is about all it's gonna handle. Went ahead and got this one off. Got these over here cut off so I can get them drilled and prepped to kill them off. And like I say, while I was at it, I just went ahead and got the remainder of them. Now like I say, what I'm going to do to kill these, I'm going to use 100% undiluted 5% white vinegar, and I'll drill the stumps with half inch hole, as far as my drill can go, and periodically I'm going to fill them up with vinegar. That will eventually kill them, and later, once winter arrives, I'll use charcoal, lighter fluid, and start burning them out. And I'll get as much as I can burn out. The roots in that, those are going to have to come out with axes and hatchets. And then early spring, I'll till this ground up because it hasn't had a thing done to it in 10, 12 years. So I got them all down. Got the hackberries down. And I'll prep the stumps either late this afternoon or tomorrow morning, and start the process of killing them. So we gotta get all this toted off to the burn pile. Then we'll start planting some tomatoes and green peppers. Well, all that didn't go as planned. What I meant to do was take that large chivot Chinese privet stump I cut down, and I was gonna throw it up on the burn pile. A little too short. So I went ahead and got that old Rubbermaid two-step little stool. I could climb up on it and give me a little more height. So just as I sat the camera down and went to swing that tree trunk up on the pile, let me show you what happened. Well, there's part of that whole Rubbermaid plastic step thingy. There's the other step. Like I say, this is, I was about to throw this on, it snapped on me. I fell back across this. Now, I don't think anything's broken, except my pride and for being so stupid. That Rubbermaid step stool was old, hadn't given any indication of being unstable. But today was the day that it decided to give out. I'll never buy another one. It'll be aluminum or nothing for me from now on. I'm sure I'm going to have a nice bruise on my right hip. We're going to go ahead and get up. Hopefully nothing's broken, because I'm here by myself. My cell phone's in the house. Of course, my kids get on to me for leaving my cell phone either in the car or the house all the time. They're always saying, well, what if you fall? You're working on the roof. You're doing this. You're cutting down trees. I said, well, hopefully somebody will pass the road and see me. I'm gonna try to get up now. Oh. Oh. Yep. I'm gonna be a little sore. Try to get a shot there, backside. I don't know if you can see it. But yep. That right there. I dropped it as a ladder broke, and then I fell right on top of it with my right cheek and my hip. I already tell it's going to be sore later on, but it doesn't appear to be broken. So we're going to take a little breather, and we're going to continue on.